गुड मॉर्निंग टू ऑल ऑफ यू।
गुड मॉर्निंग सर।
हाँ गुड मॉर्निंग। दिस टुडे क्लास वी विल सी व्हाट आर द कॉन्सेप्ट, व्हाट आर द मीनिंग ऑफ द करिकुलम फ्रेमवर्क, करिकुलम एंड सिलेबस। ओके, सो दैट वी विल सी इन दिस क्लास। Any one of you that who can tell that what is the curriculum framework, or we will try to answer the generic question that what is the difference between the curriculum framework, curriculum and syllabus? What are these three things? Because it looks like a same, and most of the time we confuse that when what to use, which one we should use when. Can anybody tell me that what are these three things? Anybody?
Curriculum framework is the details, plan or idea that we have to do the learning, total learning outcome, that is curriculum framework. And curriculum is the totality of experience. Syllabus is the only the curricular part that we have performed in the classroom situation.
So, this is what the Ashutosh conception about the curriculum framework, curriculum and the syllabus. Anybody else?
Sir, curriculum framework means it's an organized plan or standard learning outcome as a guide.
Okay. It is a plan. Or anybody? This one? This much only?
So it is a plan to set the standards of learning and its outcomes.
Plan for setting outcome for the learners. Okay. Apart from that, other cells also there, na? Kavita, are you here?
Yes, sir.
So, what is your conception? If you
same,
have...
Everybody has the same.
Achha, so just tell me one thing. There is a one position paper on curriculum, syllabus and text that I have uploaded in the portal also, and I have told you already that all the required material is in the portal. So how many of you have seen that position paper? I think nobody. I think so. And how many of you have went through the NCF 2005? Achha, Ashish has seen that. Okay. So what you have seen there, Ashish, in that position paper, what is written?
Model platform mein dekha tha sir.
हाँ देखे थे, बट यू हैव नॉट रेड दैट। आप उसको रीडिंग किए?
नहीं सर, आप जिस जिस क्लास का पढ़ाते हैं वही सब पढ़ रहा था, आगे का नहीं पढ़ा।
तो आज तो सब खत्म हो गया था, तो बाकी रिमेनिंग चीज आज डिस्कशन होगा। दैट वाज ऑब्वियस ना, बिकॉज आप देखेंगे कि रिसेंट करिकुलम रिफॉर्म, उसमें फिर है रैशनल, ऑब्जेक्टिव, प्रिंसिपल, डिजाइन, मटेरियल, ऑल द थिंग्स वी हैव फिनिश्ड ऑलरेडी। ओके, सो लेट इट बी, नो प्रॉब्लम, वी विल सी हियर। सो
सर मुझे कोई भी,
सर मुझे कोई भी,
हाँ, कौन तू?
हेलो सर, एक्चुअली कॉलेज में फेरमंग का
फेरमंग
का एक एग्जांपल ना,
एक एग्जांपल
तो वो एक घर
डा
और बनना जाए,
इंजीनियर
इंजीनियर का तो
प्लान करे,
और एस्टीमेट करे,
एस्टीमेट
माने ए डिटेल में ए कामटा करले घर डा सुंदर देखा जीवो,
सुंदर देखा
जीवो, सेटा को अप्लाई को आला करिकुलम,
करिकुलम
आ सिलेबस ता हला कोन,
सिलेबस ता हला कोन,
तापर तापर जो मिस्त्री माने असली एतीटा दिन में हम एटा कंप्लीट करू, एटा एतीटा दिन में कंप्लीट करू, रंगमिति दर एतीटा दिन में कंप्लीट करू, एतीटा दिन में घर डा सेट तैयार करू, सेटा को आला ता सिलेबस,
अच्छा आउटा करिकुलम फ्रेमवर्क कौन कहिले, फ्रेमवर्क टा हेलो आशीष, आर यू गेटिंग मी?
हाँ सर, कौन तू?
हाँ सर, कौन तू?
हाँ, ये कैन यू रिपीट व्हाट यू हैव टोल्ड अबाउट द करिकुलम फ्रेमवर्क, कैन यू रिपीट वंस अगेन?
सर सेबे कहिले से जो करिकुलम फ्रेमवर्क ता हला, तर जो डिजाइन ता इंजीनियर बनेला एते दिन ने मुदा को माने एमटी एमटी करले एते दिन भीतर भरटा मो सारी होई,
भरटा मो सारी होई,
हाउ हाउ हाउ
डिटेल बोले इंडिकेटर ता भलो देखा जीवो, से उठला तर करिकुलम माने ए ए आ किंतु
आ किंतु
इला बस्ता हला कोन तापर मिस्त्री तो आसीले से मान देखिले कि आमे एती दिन रे घरटा एती दिन थरो राज्य मिस्त्री तीन करियो, बढे मिस्त्री तीन करियो, तापर एती दिन रे कंप्लीट करियो, बे सुंदर देखा जियो, एटा को अलग थिला बस, अर्थात पढे तो बड सेंस माने सेटा तो डिजाइन ता उपर तो माने फिनिशिंग दउती सिला बस्ता हो।
हाउ 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 ओके, सो यू आर राइट आशीष, लेकिन वी हैव टू ऐड समथिंग मोर, आई विल जस्ट बिल्ड द डिस्कशन, देन वी विल गो थ्रू द डेफिनेशन दैट इज रिफ्लेक्टिंग इन योर स्क्रीन, आई थिंक दैट पीपीटी इज विजिबल टू योर स्क्रीन, इजंट इट, इज इट विजिबल? आई थिंक सो, इट मस्ट बी विजिबल।
ओके सो,
हाँ, so we will build with the example given by the Asis. Asis is saying that curriculum is a something when we plan. Suppose that he has given an example for a building that someone is interested to make a building. Then the plan that what are the things required, what will be there, how it will be there, what will be the stage. Your voice is not clear. Can you type in the chat box? Are you type in the chat box because I'm not able to hear you. Okay, please type in the chat box. Okay, so he was saying like that, but within that there is a one more requirement. When you are finalizing that. Which type of a house, how much carpet area of the house it will be, before that you have to consider about the different parameter, that is the structure of a family, that is the one thing, it may be the occupation of the family members, it may be like the locality where the family is staying. Why I am telling, suppose that the family members are working, means they are doing a job in a academic field or in a company, means they are salaried person, and some family is based upon the agriculture, so the structure of a house will be different, because those family who are involved in the agricultural work, they require a house where there is a lot of storage capacity, it may be like that there should be some area to keep the cattles. It may be required that they may keep the agricultural equipment somewhere. So that type of a consideration is required. If the family is a salaried family, means they are doing a somewhere job and they are dependent upon the salary. So their structure of a house will be different. If a family is staying in an urban area, suppose that a metropolitan city I am taking, or better to take a Bhuvaneshwar, or someone is staying in a village, so the requirement of a house will be different and accordingly the structure will change. Suppose that if you have a joint family, okay, where the grandparents, the brother and their wives and their children are staying. So the structure of a house will be different. The point of saying is that when you try to fix that which kind of a house you require, before that you are supposed to consider the different parameters. Okay, like that if you are from the upper middle class family or a middle class family, so you may require a garage. Okay, if you have a 3-4 children in your house, so you may require some recreational areas. The point of saying is that whenever we plan, our planning is dependent on certain other parameters also. And that is very much required to consider. If we won't consider those things, then our planning will not be very much appropriate. So likewise, a curriculum is also a plan. And which kind of a plan? To achieve the educational aim that we have decided. Whatever the aim, educational aim we have decided, in order to fulfill those aims, we have a curriculum framework. Like that, one example I will give. I think someone of you have messaged. Okay, so it is an example is given by the Bibhu. Okay, sorry. So I thought it is Asis. Sorry, I was unable to recognize the voice of a Bibhu. Okay, so I was talking about that, for example, when we see the new education policy, that the National Education Policy 2020, one of the focus area in that education policy is the vocationalization of education. And that finds that whatever we have did till now, out of the work, that is the outcome of the work, is that we are able to give a vocational education to only 5% of the population between the age group of 19 to 24. That is the age group of the student in the higher education. Whereas when we find the other countries like America, it is about 50%. South Korea, it is almost 96%. And it is a demand of the time that the student must have a vocational skill so that they can start their own entrepreneurship, they can start their own work to have a better livelihood opportunity. Because it won't be possible to engage all the population in the government sector as a job or in a private sector. They should also initiate something. Even in order to consume that population, they must have a certain skill. And that skill is lacking. And that's why there is a problem of unemployability. That is the baseline survey they have did. And that's why they have made one aim, that to provide a vocational education to the student. So that is the one aim. I am coming with the aim. So in order to achieve that aim, we will have a curriculum framework. Curriculum framework is at a higher hierarchy among curriculum framework, curriculum and a syllabus. So one of the aim is to provide a vocational education. So in order to, how it will be provided, that the curriculum framework will talk, and while talking with that, it will consider the individual need, the societal need, even the requirement of the industry. Industry means all the area where the working people can be consumed, like agriculture is also an industry. Okay, industry is not like that where the big machines are there. Every sector where a person can go for a work is an industry. So we have to keep in the mind the demand of the industry. We have to keep in the mind the necessity of a society. We have to keep in the mind the interest of the individual. Interest means their individual differences, their strength, their special need also. In the name of a vocationalization, I cannot train all the children, student in a particular area, suppose that for agriculture. No, we cannot, because that will not fulfill the demand of an industry, because we don't have agriculture as alone a industry. We have a lot of the industry. So someone is required to train in the mechanical field, someone is required to train in the electrical field, like that. So the curriculum is a plan to achieve the educational aim by considering the individual need, the societal need, the country need, the industry need, and in order to provide all those things, what kind of a learning experience will be required, means what will be the structure of a learning experiences. That's why if you have went through the curriculum framework, National Curriculum Framework, NCF 2005, you must have seen that it talks that what are the aim of education, what is the mission and the vision of a school education, and in order to achieve aim, mission and vision of a school education, what are the different sub component, like a mathematics education, assessment, evaluation, like that there are the various sub content. So within that, what will be the plan, means what is the plan of a mathematics education to achieve the mission, vision and aim of a school education, what should be in the social science education in order to achieve that, what will be in the geography education, language education, what should be the assessment plan, what should be the teacher training, okay, like that, to achieve the higher educational aim. And they suggest the learning modality of a learning experiences also. And that's why we say that NCF 2005 talks a paradigm shift from the behaviorism to constructivism, we used to say, and it is a fact also. Because in order to achieve the aim that they have visualized, mission and vision they have visualized, the constructivist paradigm will be, approach will be more appropriate one. Because specifically when we talk about the mathematics education, it talks about the mathematization of a thought process. So how the mathematization will happen, how the creativity, critical thinking, problem solving will be developed, with the constructivist approach of engaging the learner in a learning situation. That is, so this is the curriculum framework. And if you have seen the previous curriculum frameworks also, like a curriculum framework of 2088 and 75 curriculum framework is the first curriculum framework we had in our country, that is known as a curriculum framework for 10 years schooling. So this is the first curriculum framework that we had in our country. I will upload all the curriculum framework also for making a comparison. When you will find a time, you can compare, go through those curriculum frameworks document, and you can compare that how there is a shift, how there is a change in the mission and the vision of a school education, how there is a change in the aim of a school education. And with the changing aim, with the changing objectives, mission and a vision, what kind of a shift they are proposing. Okay, so that I will upload, and you can see that also, that today itself I will upload. You can go and see, that will be uploaded in the third bit of a first unit, because our learning portal is organized as a bit wise and a unit wise. So you go there and you will find, after this class I will upload, so you can understand. And that's why when we talk about the curriculum, this picture I have taken from the position paper, syllabus, curriculum, syllabus and text. Okay, so it is a, if you have gone through that, you must have seen this picture. So when we talk about the curriculum, there are the foundations of a curriculum. It may be visible in a very small font, because I have taken the screenshot. If could I have drawn, then I could have made the font bigger than this. So you will find that there are three components when we talk about the curriculum framework. One is the foundations of curriculum, then there is a core curriculum, and then at last we come to a curriculum details. So first is the consideration of the foundation. Consideration of the foundation, you will see that the assumptions concerning human beings and a society, that I have talked, the individual need, societal need, industry need, like that, the contextualization, in which context you are proposing something. Because when we are proposing something, we must know the context. And then other thing is the epistemological assumptions, the organization of the knowledge. Assumptions about the learning means the psychology of a learning, learning theories, assumed understanding of the child and her context. I don't know why they have written her. I think a better word is the their, because her is not a gender biased term, it is a gender biased, okay, gender neutral term we should use. Okay, so the individual difference, the interest of a child, the strength of a child, that needs to be taken care while we are thinking of framing a curriculum framework. And then obviously it will come with a aim of education, stage specific objective, not a objective related to the content, stage specific means a class 9, what will be the objective of teaching mathematics, class 9, what will be the objective of teaching language, like that. And then the principle of content selection and organization. In order to fulfill the aim, we will have an objective. In order to fulfill the objective, we will have a content. Because the content is a medium through which we want to achieve the objective and ultimately the aim of our education. And then the pedagogy, what pedagogy will be there. Like the NCF 2005 suggests a different type of a pedagogical approach based upon the constructivist paradigm. Then how it will be assessed, evaluated, because the evaluation should also be focused to the aim, objective, content, methods. For example, if we trying to assess the creativity, accordingly the assessment plan will be there. If we are trying to assess the problem solving, accordingly the content will be there, like that. And ultimately the specific objective and a content selection will go to the syllabus, that becomes a part of a syllabus, and the method, it becomes a part of pedagogy. Then the material, it becomes a part of the textbook and a TLM, and the evaluation becomes that how it will be, learning will be evaluated. So this is what the curriculum framework talks about. Okay, so is it okay to you, or do you have any question? Okay, so if you have any question, you just write in the chat box. I will respond those queries. So meanwhile, I will proceed towards the curriculum. We have seen a curriculum framework. Now we will see the curriculum. You can put your question in the chat box. At the end of this session, we will see that. When we talk about the curriculum, as you were able to see here, that this part becomes as a part of a curriculum. So curriculum is a document which talks about the content. What content will be there? Because at a curriculum framework, we have fixed the aim, and in order to achieve those aim, we have fixed the other things also. So now we have to plan for the achieving those aim by considering the other parameters, like the individual interest, societal interest, and the industry interest, like the other things. So we have to consider. So now we'll try to come on that how we will achieve. So we will achieve by incorporating the content as per the requirement. Then the methodology of teaching, like that. And the curriculum also talks about the what is to be taught, how is to be taught, and how it will be evaluated. So this is the part of a curriculum. Generally, the curriculum is prepared by the highest authority in the educational system. We have a highest authority, the government, and the government has a given a responsibility of preparing a curriculum at a national level to the NCERT. At a state level, the SCERT. In some of the state, there is a TENSCERT, like a Orisha. That is for the school. For the college, UGC proposes a model curriculum. Based upon that, the university, college or institute, they prepare their own curriculum. For a teacher education, NCTE proposes a model curriculum. Based upon that, we prepare a curriculum for the university or for the college. Okay. So, but since the curriculum covers all the things like a content, like a methods of teaching, like a methods of evaluation, like that. Sometimes they are put together with the syllabus also, core curriculum, but in fact it is a little bit a different thing. When we will see the syllabus, we will be able to better understand the things. This picture also I have taken from a position paper, and it is a part of that picture only. So here when we talk about the core curriculum, that is a curriculum, it will have a aim of education, stage specific objective, like that we have discussed. So that is a part of a curriculum. Okay, but when we will go to the syllabus, it will have a specific content. In a curriculum, they may say that as a content, you can incorporate algebra in mathematics. Suppose specifically if I am talking algebra, trigonometry, arithmetic, or a commercial mathematics like a profit loss, simple interest, compound interest. So they will tell, because these are the content which is required to achieve the aim and aligned with the societal need, individual need, industrial need, like that. But the syllabus will give the specific content within the trigonometrical identities. What specific will be there in the class 8, class 9, class 10. Within the arithmetic, what will be in the class 8, class 9, class 10, like that. Here in the curriculum, there may not be a specific. So, that is the curriculum. And thus, the syllabus is a document that contains all the portion of a concept covered in a subject. Means what concept will be covered in the subject. It is a descriptive in nature because it will describe everything. Content, methodology, assessment plan, even the what kind of assignment, homework, like that, everything it will talk about. Curriculum is a prepared by the NCERT or SCERT. But when we talk about the syllabus, it is fixed by the examination board. And that's why you will find that your state board, CBSE board, ICSE board, they have a different syllabus. But they will focus to us particular curriculum that is set out by the country or a state government. Okay, so syllabus is a document which suggests content, methods of teaching, assessment, all things with a objective that is already identified in a curriculum. And it is a stage specific. Okay. So, now we have come to the end of this discussion about the curriculum framework, curriculum and a syllabus. So, now we will have a question answer session regarding that. Are you getting me?
Yes, sir.
Hello. So is there any question or any doubt or any clarification you need from me, anything? Hello. No question. अच्छा देयर इज वन क्वेश्चन फ्रॉम आशीष epistemological assumptions okay so Asis when we talk about the epistemological assumption before that I will like to connect it with the philosophy because the epistemology when we talk it is a philosophical term I think you have been taught about the educational philosophy na it was there in your syllabus first year mein tha educational philosophy can anybody say me you don't reply me that's why I am demotivated
yes sir
education childhood and growing up learning and teaching contemporary
yes sir
education philosophy was there na so there is a three terms metaphysics epistemology and axiology
yes sir
have
yes,
you
sir.
heard about these three terms
yes sir
then what is the epistemology
it is related to knowledge it is related to values
it is related to knowledge and axiology
related to the matter inversion
and the metaphysics
related to the matter inversion
हाँ तो आप तो जानते हैं then why you are asking question to me see there are other things also because I will not go in that as per the time constraint and as per the limitation of this paper also but for the connecting just I am telling when we talk about there is a three basic component of a philosophy the one component that talks about the value system that is the axiology another one is the metaphysics which talks about the things which is happening in the society physical world okay but apart from these two there is another component of a philosophy that talks about the knowledge and a structure of a knowledge the structure of knowledge when we talk means how the different sub knowledge system is linked with the main knowledge system I will give the example also I think it may be very abstract for you to understand but I will give the example so the epistemology talks about the knowledge system and the knowledge structure for sake of example when I take a example from a mathematics geometry so there are different knowledge structure in mathematics like one knowledge structure is related to the basic geometrical objects like that the line point plane rays line segment then when we talk about the plane then there will be a geographical geometrical figures like a parallelogram like a rectangle like a square like a sphere like a triangle I have talked okay but this is the one knowledge structure one knowledge system that talks about the geometrical structure in two plane that is a euclidean system of geometrical objects but there is a non euclidean also like a cone like a sphere okay like a cuboid so this that knowledge structure is linked with the previous knowledge structure because whenever we are talking about the sphere that is linked to the circle when we talk about the cuboid it is linked with the cubes and the rectangles when we talk about the cone it is related with the circle and the triangle so this is the one knowledge system this is the another knowledge system So it is how it is linked, how is the structure of a knowledge in that. And mathematical knowledge are structured hierarchically, however somewhere it breaks. In the science also, most of the scientific concept and a knowledge structure is hierarchically structured, because in order to understand the anatomy of a and the physiology of a human body, you must go through the cells, cell structure, different type of a cell like that. It is based upon that. So that is the knowledge structure, and epistemology talks about that. And epistemological assumptions means considering the knowledge structure in that particular discipline. Because if you want to prepare a curriculum or a curriculum framework or a syllabus even, you must consider the hierarchical structure of the knowledge system of a particular subject and a discipline. Okay, that is the epistemological assumptions. Okay, is it clear to you?
Yes, sir. Thank you, sir. Yes, sir.
Okay.
Thank you, sir.
Any other question? Okay. So, shall we stop this class here? Okay. So, thank you for being with me. Have a nice day.